visuals coming in from Liverpool, Bristol, Hull, Belfast. Four cities at least located in different corners of the United Kingdom. Scuffles breaking out, bricks and bottles thrown, as on one side were anti-immigration protesters, faced groups that are anti-racism. Look at this. Violent disorder swept several cities. We are told even police officers were very seriously and critically injured. Properties were damaged. This was in one of the most widespread rioting that the country has seen in 13 years. It happened after three young girls, children, who were stabbed to death in northwest England. And that's when the protests have started. Eyewitness video shows protests are targeting a shopfront in Liverpool. Some rioters kicked and beat the window to the pool and much worse. Then remember, it turned into full-blown riots. Hundreds of anti-immigration protesters erupted in towns and cities after what officials say appears to be fake information that spread rapidly and on social media, that the suspect in Monday's knife attack at a children's dance class in Southport was a radical Muslim migrant. Protests by anti-immigration and anti-Muslim demonstrators then continued, while the officials have said there is no clarity and confirmation on that.
See him driving. You see him?
That's long though, isn't it?
A number of British police officers were injured, as some of these far-right group members as well faced off with the cops. Then there were anti-racism protesters on the other side. This is in cities and towns across the UK. In Bristol, the police had to use officers with dogs to push the protesters back. Bricks were thrown at the cops, and many of them have received serious injuries. Now, specifically, areas that have been hit are Belfast, Manchester and Nottingham. UK Home Secretary Wet Cooper has said that criminal violence and disorder has no place on the streets of Britain, warning the rioters will have to pay the price on this. Cooper's comments after a number of British police officers were critically injured as protesters that not only clashed with each other from different groups, but also with the cops. Look at the city centre. These are the streets in the east coast of UK city of Hull were left strewn with burning debris. Violent disorder, that means, that happened. Videos shared on social media show riot police clearing parts of the city. Minor scuffles were also reported. Bins and street furniture were set on fire. Cars appeared to have been set ablaze. This is, remember, across cities in the UK and is leading to a lot of serious concerning issues of law and order.